Hey everyone, what's up? It's Hannah Aline, and I am back with the third part of this episode, and finally, the last part of this episode. So if you guys didn't know, this episode was cut into three parts because it's really long. Kasi I summarized my first year experience in Letran, and it was so much. Hindi ko pa nga nalagay dito lahat. There are still things na hindi ko nalagay, pero I only put the highlights. Cause also click the I button up here if you haven't seen the.
Okay, so wala na tayong time mag-shoot ulit, kaya tamang vertical flip na lang ako ng video. If you can see, halatang-halatang flinip ko lang talaga siya kasi yung angle ng mukha ko magbabago. In 3, 2, ay, angle ng mukha ko, ano daw? Angle kung saan ako nakaharap. In 3, 2, one.
First and second part of this, kasi it would be better, no, it would be best, no, better lang naman if you have already watched the first and second part, kasi ang pangit naman panoodin yung third part na hindi mo pinapanood yung first and second part. Pero if you wanna prioritize third part, why not?
January. There was nothing vlog worthy. It was filled with learnings and studyings and pandas. So fast forward to February. I was asked to join a declamation in February, and I looked like a bride that was stood up, but technically it was a bride that was stood up by the guy. According to the piece, the bride was stood up by her groom to be. So here's a clip, a short clip, because it's super nakakahiya.
I look. But where is the groom?
Hindi bago sa
akin. Jonathan.
Okay.
This is not how playwrights picture love. Romeo died for Juliet. I from this fourth is B. Han Suyin called this a many splendor thing.
Nice, wala sa tono.
And Princess Margaret gave up the ground for love. Jonathan needs to find out that she's a square. And all mother can say is, this is most embarrassing! I should have joined the Crusaders for blessed singleness. I should have known it with my father confessor, Father Martin said, when I talked about Jonathan.
Diba, nagkalat, nagkalat. Tignan niyo yung heels, tignan niyo yung hat, nakakalat, sige.
Hindi lang yung makeup yung makalat.
But I didn't. That phone keeps on ringing. Alright, mother, alright, I'm answering it. Don't you darling me, Mr. Jonathan Anderson! Marriage at 18. How do you like
joining the declamation at the Colegio is really fun, and it helped me enhance my emotions. March. A lot has happened. We had a lot of fetas, and then there came the student council. I joined the student council, but at first I was having a second thought of joining or not joining. Kasi March is filled with petas, schoolworks, paperworks, and stuff. But I had to balance them.
The thing that I'm pertaining to when it comes to balancing is balancing your school works and the campaign, because campaign is really a busy thing to do kasi your classmates will be busy at their classroom doing listening to the lesson while we go room to room para mag-campaign, and there are so much preparations before the campaign. That's why I am having a second thought. Thankfully, through God's grace, I was able to balance campaigning and studying. Kasi it's just a matter of knowing what to prioritize and time management.
Magandang gabi, Letranista! Sa gitna ng dilim, naglilihaw pa rin! Pag-ilaw! Si Club Letranista! Students working for innovation, true knowledge, leadership, action, and benevolence! Maraming salamat po!
Why run for academic senator? So I was part of the Partido Siklab Letranista, students working for innovation through knowledge, leadership, action, and benevolence. Hi Siklab fam! So I was part of the Partido Siklab Letranista, and it was really fun. It was like my first ever family in Letran, which made me feel welcome. We took care of each other, and there was a warm feeling, you know, I can't explain, pero it made me explore what it feels to be with other Letranistas, hindi lang yung sa mga classmates mo, kasi I get to meddle with other grade levels like 12, 11, and different strands. And it was really fun, it was enjoying. It helped me enhance my communication skills with other people. It made me adapt to different environments when you're like talking to people in a group na there will be quiet people you're talking to, there will be people na walang response to you, there will be people na maingay, there will be people na magdadadad. Don't judge people while you're talking to them. Just show them, just always don't forget to do an eye contact. Should be a good attention grabber. Like that. Just look at them and smile, and don't ever do this, point, point. Just do that whenever talking to other people. Okay, tips na to ha on how to talk to people, but here are the things that I learned and I want to share to you because you might go. Because you might be needing this when you talk to other people or when presenting in class. Be a great, kanina ko pa sinasabi, but be a great attention grabber. Hindi naman yung pabibo, pero yung you wanna gain their listening ear. Yeah. And be pleasing. Always smile to people. Pero if you're giving a strong emotion, like you're telling them to not to do this thing, don't smile naman that much kasi baka isipin nila niloloko mo sila, or you don't mean what you're saying. Basta mean whatever you say whenever you're communicating to other people, and promise, don't judge them. It might turn out that they remembered you. Kasi after we talk, we had some taglines kasi in our spiels, and after the campaign in one room, I just heard my name, like, my ako si Hannah Elaine Matusalem, and all that stuff. And it's really fun kasi other people also do the Partido Siklab Letranista, even if they're not our classmates, even if I don't know them. It's good. Okay, we're done with that. I'll stop bubbling about that. Let's proceed to the next. So nasa March na ako. April, we didn't have that much classes na. I took advanced classes ata on April, yeah. May, bakasyon. I didn't have something to do in school. April, May, June. Yeah, June. I had something on June, which is my summer work immersion. So, we were given the choice of to take either your work, kasi when you reach your 12th grade of your senior year, you are required to take your work immersion, wherein you will be exposed and you will be working, you will be exposed to work-related environments related to your chosen field or strand. Wow, memories ko pa! Yun yung definition na binigay sa amin ng teacher namin. But, eh, about that, I chose, we were given two choices, which is to do your work immersion during classes on second semester, during classes, during the school year, during the academic year, or then the other one, which is to take it on summer, para you won't really have that much pressure and stress during the year, para you don't have to worry about work immersion. Kasi in work immersion, you may be in Letran, Manila, you may have your work immersion inside the colegio or outside the colegio. So I took mine, they assigned me outside the colegio, and it was with one export. So I had a vlog there because we have a PETA in that subject wherein we have to share our insights, our experiences, and I'm not thinking of uploading it, but I will give you some short clips I have in that vlog. Yes, so that is it for my experience so far in my first year in Letran. Yung work immersion, it's not really my first year experience. It's on my 12th grade na, but I'm sharing it with you since nakaabot pa naman ng July. It's like first week of July na. And so, thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you've learned a lot and I've shared my thoughts clearly. Pero, if you have any questions about Letran Manila, just comment down below. I'll try my best to answer it. Any questions about this strand, about their senior high school in Letran, just comment down below. That's the end of my first episode for my back to school series. Yeah. And thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you so much for reaching the end of this video. Thank you so much for going with me, experiencing with me, re-experience it again, what it is like to be an 11th grader in Letran, a transferee, to be a new student in Letran, because it was really convenient to adopt because they have this welcoming ambience talaga in Letran. Don't put judgments on people kasi we are all under construction, so you don't have the right to do, we don't have the right to put judgments in on a group or in anything. Kasi we all have our iniquities, we all have our imperfections which hindi dapat natin ipuna sa ibang tao. So, dami ko na sinabi, but it is true. I just wanna share that with you. We are all under construction, under God's hands. Letran might not be your first choice, but Letran would definitely be your best choice.